Hey there, readers, and welcome to our last library live before our fall break. I hope you all have exciting plans for the next week, and I hope you're going to do a whole lot of reading next week. Last week, we read one of my favorite books, Triangle, by Mac Barnett and John Clausen, and I think a lot of you really enjoyed that book. So I thought today we might read the sequel for that book, Square. So if you remember Triangle and Square are playing sneaky tricks on each other in that book. And today, Square is going to be our main character, and we're going to meet a new character, Circle. So let's check it out.
Square.
By Mac Barnett and John Clausen. This is Square. This is Square's secret cave. Every day, Square goes down into his cave and takes a block from the pile in the ground. He pushes the block up and out of the cave. He brings the block to the pile at the top of a hill. This is his work. One day, while Square was doing his work, Circle floated by. "Square," said Circle, "you are a genius. I did not know you were a sculptor."
"Ah, yes," said Square. "What is a sculptor?"
"Oh, a sculptor shapes blocks into art," said Circle.
"Ah, yes," said Square. "I see what you mean." But he did not really see what she meant.
"This is a wonderful sculpture," said Circle. "It looks just like you."
Square looked at his block.
"Yes, I suppose it is wonderful." "Now," said Circle, "you must do one of me."
"Oh," said Square.
"I will come back for it tomorrow. Goodbye, genius."
"Circle,"
said Square, "I think I should tell you something."
But she was already gone.
"Oh, dear, dear, dear," said Square. He studied the block. "I have to make this block look like Circle," he said. "Circle is perfect, so I must make this perfect."
Square got to work shaping the block.
"Oh, crumbs," said Square. "This is not perfect." "Oh, dirt," said Square. "This is much worse."
He went back to work. He worked and worked and worked and worked.
"Ah!"
cried Square. He had carved the whole block away. There was nothing left. He was surrounded by rubble.
"Whatever is the opposite of perfect, that is what this is. I must stay up all night and figure this out."
Square fell asleep. The next morning, Square woke up wet.
He despaired. "What have I done? I push blocks. I do not shape them. I am not a genius."
"Hello, genius," said Circle. "I am early."
"Oh, dear," whispered Square. "Are you finished?" asked Circle.
"Oh, yes," said Square. "I am finished." Circle peered down.
"Oh, my," she said.
"It was beautiful. It was beguiling."
"It is perfect," said Circle.
"It is?" asked Square.
"Yes," said Circle.
"You are a genius," said Circle. But was he really?
I hope you enjoyed this story, readers. I'll tell you my favorite part about this book is when you are making art, you don't always have a good plan, and your plan doesn't always work out like you want it to. And I think Square shows us that in this book. He thinks his plan has failed, but really Circle thinks it's this miraculous work of art. We never really know what someone else might find beautiful. And I really enjoy that about this story. Thanks for joining us today, readers, and we will see you after the fall break when we get back to Library Live. Bye, friends.